Students, hope all of you are doing well. Today I'm going to discuss about chapter number 4 worksheet. Okay, so let's see the first question you see here. So these things already I discussed, introduction to the negative numbers. So what is natural number, whole numbers, what is integer, positive integer, negative integer, number line, those things already you learn, and how to use the number lines and do addition and subtraction, those things already I discussed in my previous video. So in the last worksheet, I have given some questions, state true or false. So the first question is that all natural numbers. So students, you know that which are the natural numbers. So 1, 2, 3, 4 up to is a endless number is the natural numbers. Is starting, it beginning, it beginning with 1, is always beginning with 1, and then it is, the number is increasing, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, like this way. So those are the natural numbers. So all natural numbers are whole numbers. So at first you have to know that what is whole number. So whole numbers, you know that the all natural numbers including 0. So but in 0 is not in the natural number, 0 is not a natural number. So but in whole numbers with including 0, the all natural numbers are called whole numbers. So all natural numbers are whole numbers, this statement is not true, because that 0 is not in counting in a natural numbers, but in whole numbers, all natural numbers including 0 is called whole numbers. So all natural numbers are whole numbers, this statement is false. Next question is the all integers are natural numbers. So all integers, you know that or integers are two types, positive integer as well as negative integer. Okay, so positive integer like this, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, plus 5, so those are the positive integer, and negative integer is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, like this way. Okay, so all integers are natural numbers. So you think about that positive integer, so though that are the natural numbers, but negative integer are we will not count in the natural numbers. So negative integers is not count in natural numbers. So that's why all integers means positive and negative, including 0 is so 0 is not is neither a positive integer nor a negative integer. So all positive and negative integers are natural numbers, this statement is not true. So all integers are natural numbers, this statement is false. So next question is the question number 3, all positive integers are whole numbers. So all positive integers are, positive integer means plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, 5, 5. But in whole numbers, positive integer as well as negative integer including 0 is also is a whole numbers. Because in this chapter we learn about the numbers that lie to the left of 0. So right of 0 is all positive numbers and left of 0 is all negative numbers on a number line extending endlessly in both directions. So this statement is false, that's why. And question number 4, 0 is a positive integer. So we know that 0 is in your book, that statement is given, 0 is neither a positive or nor a negative integer. Okay, so see here in book you see that zero is neither positive or not a negative integer. It is however an integer, it does not belong to the collection of integer. So we cannot say zero is a integer. Okay, we cannot collect it in a integer number. So question number 5, addition of two negative integers results in a positive integer. So you think about the two negative integers. So suppose is if for example I am taking the numbers hoche plus the negative 2 integers. So minus 3 is a negative integer and addition of 2 in negative integers, so minus of 2. So you see that the minus 3 is a negative integer, minus 2 is a negative integer. So when we will add these two numbers, what result we will get? So if you draw the number line, so here is a 0. So this side all numbers is positive, this side all number is negative. So because that right side of 0 is all numbers is positive, like this way, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, like this way. And this side all number is negative, minus 1, minus 2. We extend this line, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5. So you see here, where is minus 3? Minus 3 is here, so add minus 2. So you see that, so we have to go, the minus sign is indicates that the left side or right side. So of course this negative sign is here, so that's why we have to go to the left side. So minus 3 here, after that you have to add two more step in left of minus 3. So one step and first step, and this is the first step, this is the second step. So so we will reach here. So this is the answer. So minus 3 plus or minus 2 is equal to minus 5. So this is the answer. So you see here, addition of two negative numbers. So here I am adding two negative numbers addition, then result in positive integer. See here, result is in positive integer or negative integer. See here, negative integer. So this statement also is false. Addition of two negative numbers result in a positive integer. This statement is false. Okay, hope students you understood when this type of question will come, you use your own example and try to prove it. It will come, the result will come in positive or negative. You can find out. Okay, so that will be easy to find out that statement is true or false. Okay, so hope students you understood this, all this question answer. So question number B, add the following. So this is the first question, minus 8 plus or plus 5. And so how to solve this type of problems, these things already I discussed in my previous video, but again I am discussing here. See the first question here, yes, this one. So minus 8 plus or plus 5. So at first you have to draw the number line, that will be easy to find out the result. So you see here, where is minus 8? Minus 8 is here, so left of 0. So minus 8 is here. So after that you start, see, we will start minus at minus 8, then plus or plus 5. So move plus 5. So we have to take five steps to the right, because this sign indicates the right of minus 8. So right of minus 8 means is positive. So you move 5 steps to the right, as plus 5 is a positive integer, because plus 5 is a, that sign indicates that it is a positive integer. So that's why we will go to the right of minus 8. So after taking the plus 5 step, so you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. After taking the 5 step, we'll reach minus 3. So minus 3, thus the minus 8 plus of plus 5 is equal to minus 2. So this is the result. Okay. So when you solve this type of problem, you have to write this way, that mistake will not done. So you please do it. Then a question number B, minus 7 plus or minus 4. How to solve this type of problem? So some rules already I discussed in my previous video. So you see here, minus 7 plus or minus 4. So you have to take the sum of absolute values. So you see this minus 7, what is the absolute values of minus 7? So simply you take the mode, so you minus 7, you put the through parallel lines, then you will get the absolute values of 7, and then minus 4, that absolute value is 4. So minus 7 plus of minus 4, you simply add it, you remove the sign. What is the sign? Is in that two parallel lines. So you just omitted that, and then you simply add it, then you will get 7 plus 4 is equal to 11. So now you see that, place the negative sign before the sum. You see here, see these two numbers, that before the what sign is it? Is a negative sign, so that sign we will put here. Okay, so place the negative sign before the sum. So see here, minus 7 plus or minus 4 equal to minus 11. Okay, so this way you have to solve this problem. Then question number C, minus 15 plus or minus 60. So sum to of absolute value, simply you would have to take the sum absolute value of this number and this number. So minus 15 absolute value is 15, and minus 16 absolute value is 60. So simply you add it, and then you check what is the sign is in that two numbers. So these two numbers is a negative integer, and negative sign is here. So we have to place the negative sign before the sum. So simply you put the negative sign, then you will get the result, accurate result. Then question number D, So see here, this is a simple exactly that similar question of as before. So plus 5 plus or plus 27, here also you have to take the sum of absolute values. So find out the plus 5 absolute value is 5 and plus 27 absolute value is 27. So simply you add it. So see here, you add those two numbers, then you will get plus 5 plus 27 is means 27 plus 5 is equal to 32. So hence place that positive sign, because you see that these two numbers is a positive integer, so you have to put the positive sign before the sum. So plus 5 plus plus 27 is equal to plus 32. So next question, last question of our of this worksheet, that subtract plus 3 from minus 7. So how to solve this type of problem? This type of problem we will solve little bit different way. So the additive inverse of plus 3, so we have to subtract this number from this. Okay, so we have to subtract which number we have to subtract, that you find out the additive inverse of this number. So you have to find out the additive inverse of plus 3. The additive inverse of plus 3 is equal to minus 3, then thus minus 7 minus of plus 3 is equal to minus 7. Then you simply you interchange the sign, you see here, then you will get minus 7 plus or minus 3, then you will get simply minus 7. Then after you taking 3 steps to the right, to the left of minus 7, then you will get minus 10. So if for up to this, if you want to draw the number line, it will be okay to find out. Otherwise you simply you do without number line, it will be easy. But if you want to do to avoid the mistake, if you want to draw the number line, it you can. So students, you please do like this way the all those problems and you practice it. Okay, so today I'm giving you that exercise 4.2 exercise. So please you solve this at your class copy, and in my next video I will discuss that question answer of this exercise 4.2. okay, please you do it in your class copy, and in my next video I will discuss it. Okay, thank you students, bye. Hope all of you are fit and fine and healthy at your home. Stay safe at your home. Okay, bye.